Secrets. Hey, many of us have secrets, things we don't want the whole world to become aware of. But what happens if the world does become aware of those secrets? Is there anything we can do about it? Well, that takes us to this week's case. Involves a real woman. She worked for Yum's. And in her capacity, she started missing a fair amount of time from work. And people began to get a little curious as to what was going on. Her co-workers wondering when she's coming back, what's happening. And her boss, her immediate supervisor, let it be known to a number of coworkers that she was out as a result of a very severe bipolar condition. Well, coworkers began talking about this and said, oh, gee whiz, she's gone because she's crazy. I don't know that she'll ever come back. But she did come back. And when she came back, she became aware of all of the comments that were being made about the fact that she was crazy because of her bipolar diagnoses. So, she became very distressed, despondent, and she said, you know, I got to do something about this. And she sued her boss and said, you can't do this because those were private facts and you disclosed them to the public. He said, wait a second. These were facts that were known. They were in your employment file. And I just disclosed them to the people that you were working with. She said, no, you disclosed them to a few people, true, and they disclosed them to a few more people. In short, you wound up disclosing them to the public. And therefore, I am suing you, and I want to be paid for all the kinds of hassles I have now been through because it has been a nightmare for me, and I have been made a laughingstock here. I'm humiliated, and for all of those hassles, I want to be reimbursed. Okay, the case went forward. And one of the big issues that existed in the case was this particular cause of action is called disclosure, public disclosure of private facts is in fact recognized in the law. Something a lot of people haven't heard about. In the old days, it was required that the public disclosure have to take place in writing, usually through a newspaper article or something else. But in this instance, it was simply a verbal disclosure to people in the workplace. And so one of the defenses the guy over here had was saying it was not a written disclosure. She, on the other side of the coin, argued, you know what? Today we don't need written disclosures. We're in a new world, a new time and place, with media particularly where verbal comments, such as this very video blog, can be memorialized, can be held on to, can be seen again and again and again. And therefore, it doesn't have to be written. Okay, the case went forward, went up on appeal, and there the court had to deal with that issue. And what the court said with regard to that issue was, you're right, you're right. Once upon a time, the law required that disclosure of private facts had to be in writing. Today, if it is made verbally, that satisfies the requirement that, in fact, the disclosure took place, if it can be proven that it did take place. And here there is plenty of evidence that that did take place. Therefore, you do have a claim against your prior employer, against your boss, for disclosure of private facts. All right. This case teaches us a couple of things. One, it shows us how the law evolves, because once upon a time to have this cause of action, it had to be in writing. Now, a verbal statement is sufficient if it can be authenticated. Two, it also shows us about a cause of action that a lot of people aren't aware of, and that is disclosure of private facts. Reputation is important. Reputation is important. And sometimes people have engaged in conduct in their past lives, long ago, that they're not really too excited about. The kinds of things that give rise to this claim are usually things such as giving birth out of wedlock when somebody was a teenager, possibly engaging in some other kind of conduct that would bring shame to you. There was an example some years ago on Downton Abbey, the PBS show, Masterpiece Theater, in which during World War I, a woman who was a cook in the household revealed to a close friend that her nephew had died in the war, but he died as a result of being shot for cowardice. He, the man she told this to, revealed it at a dinner later. He wasn't thinking, he just revealed it, and she was mortified. Those are the kind of private facts that can cause people a lot of anguish, a lot of distress, And if someone takes those private facts and makes them available to the entire world, the law does have a remedy, does have a remedy. We don't hear about it often, but it does exist. And that's, of course, why we bring you these kind of video blogs every week, so you find out about the law, so you understand how the law works. I'm David Allen.